they lost to the same composition yesterday, he was not playing the adaptation. But by playing that now, it means that every time the Beast Mastery Hunter has his intimidation, his 5-second stun, BB will actually be able to break out of it. And those were crucial for getting kills on him, as they will pretty much go through evasion. So now Team Beast has to worry about trying to somehow proc his adaptation with the use of maybe an offensive cyclone or an intimidating shout without actually, you know, proccing that. And yeah, they catch him out of stealth, go for that quick little re-stealth.
Chicken Jack sending his pet in stealth across the map to try and get combat to deny any saps, but his pet actually got sapped, and now they've managed to trigger the adaptation of Sam, so they're going to be waiting for diminishing returns, and then Team Beast can initiate a guaranteed crowd control chain. They are still trying to find Yo-Yo and BB as they are hiding in stealth and currently invisible to their opponents, but no luck just yet in finding them. Yuffie is positioned very far back. Maybe he's afraid of a potential smoke bomb. Fortunately for him, though, BB has not talented into that, so that threat will not be available. Yo-Yo immediately attacked as soon as he shows his face, but it looks like they're actually going to be going after Select early on, pulling Barkskin, but potentially even more cooldowns as they've committed their entire arsenal. BB falling behind. He's being very aggressive in this position, forced to trade out his evasion as well. Both teams start out swinging.
Right, and we see they're playing that same strategy, and now we actually do get that adaptation force from BB from the intimidating shout. So this means he's going to be in a lot of trouble. He just got his evasion used. They have this window that if the Beastmaster Hunter can use his intimidation, it should be back up since he used it to force Sam's adaptation, and now that we see that coming back up, they have the same cooldown. He should have that stun available for BB. So if they get a CC chain with a Stormbolt trap, things are going to be very scary.
All right, Tree of Life from Select traded out, so that's a very powerful healing cooldown that he's not going to have for another 3 minutes as soon as it fades. That could be an opening for ZFA, but they need to be on defense for a little bit longer. Sam playing the Spirit Link Honor talent, so the damage is distributed to his entire team. A smart decision against such a single target crowd control based composition such as Warrior Hunter. It redistributes the damage in a way that is much more manageable as a healer and likely will allow Sam to manage his mana better. He needs to be careful to not refresh it on cooldown and try and predict crowd control chains before activating it. Chicken Jack securing a freezing trap, unfortunately breaking early. Now this burst moment will be lost as ZFA look for another swap to Select.
Right, and they're going to go for these consistent swaps onto Select. We saw ZFA, they employed the strategy yesterday when they're playing this Assassination Rogue Boomkin. They want to make these kidney swaps onto the rest of Druid, and that will put the most pressure onto them. The rest of Druids normally can keep their team relatively safe against this kind of composition, but where they fall behind is when they get those hard swaps onto him, and that's where we're going to be looking for those kill windows. Now, unfortunately, a mistake is made. They use a DR kidney shot from BB. They're still staying on this target, and I think this is where things are scary. They have the full intimidating shot. They have an intimidation stun onto BB. They have a freezing trap. DR Stormbolt comes out. BB has no vanish, no evasion. They could kill him here. They have the CC to follow it up, but the Spirit Link does get used. The Riptide is back up onto him, and BB is staying low, but he should stabilize.
Yeah, BB with a nice defensive play there, jumping back to his healer's line of sight, realizing that how dire the situation was. Yuffie, though, in hot pursuit with a double Blade Storm. It could be a possibility here that Team Beast tried to kill multiple targets. Sam under fire, trading out defensives to try to stabilize. He's trying to reapply the Spirit Link, gets in position, reapplies it. Select getting swapped to once again by ZFA, managing to pull out a Barkskin, but no other major priority cooldowns. In the meantime, Sam caught into a freezing trap, his entire team in trouble. BB caught into a Storm Bolt. He cannot shrink it as he has selected adaptation. That's a nice punish by Yuffie, putting Sam even further behind. Really no defensive cooldowns remaining for ZFA. They are on the ropes with minimal mana remaining at this point. Team Beast are looking like they are going to be taking game number one. Sam doing his best to try and persevere through the pressure,
Bullet
but now caught
son.
Into more crowd control. They're even attacking him, and this is the correct strategy against a Spirit Link Shaman. Spread your pressure out onto multiple targets. Make it difficult. Make it so he always has to refresh it and spend an exorbitant amount of mana. He's somehow still doing it, though, Dilly.
Yeah, and I actually love the strategy this KFC is doing. The Hunter's using that multi-shot. He's trying to get the Beast Cleave, trying to get that AoE damage as much as possible. Yuffie also using those Blade Storms, trying to hit everyone as much as he can to try to take advantage of the Spirit Link choice. We have Sam getting so low on mana. They get a nice tumble onto him, trying to finish them off. Their health is getting lower and lower and lower, and it's shared as a team. So even if no one is at 2% health or anything like that, they're all rotting at this point, and it's going to be extremely difficult for Sam to recover his teammate. They have the full bash into BB, get the adaptation proc here. He has vanished only has his last line of defense. They have that blind being used defensively on EU phase, trying to make that swap onto Select. They need to finish him off, but he still has his Gladius Medallion available, and I don't know if they can kill him. They use the Solar Beam, though. He has the Bark Skin on himself. DR Garou comes out. Tree of Life is forced from Select. He needs to live here, and his team can win the game.
Oh, I don't know how many times BB survives at 1% and then pulls off a miracle, so I would like to say that he's going to be going down, but it's impossible to predict with him. He just hangs on by a thread. Select is unlikely to fall with Tree of Life activated. His entire team back to full HP. Sam has been against the wall for the better part of the past 2 minutes, doing whatever he can. BB's managed to recover and escape to safety. He's looking for a re-stealth to try and initiate what could be the last stun lock of the game for their team. Sam still under fire. Cheap shots for everyone. Is Select going to choke under the pressure? This is what I was talking about in the pregame. He's playing an alternate healing class. He is really the weak link of the team. If ZFA can take advantage of it, but with crowd control secured onto Sam, BB is in trouble. Trading evasion at dangerously low health, and for some reason, BB is just fine surviving once again at 1%.
BB just pulling out miracles consistently, making sure that he can just survive at that low HP. He knows Sam is going to come out, get those riptides to save him, and Sam is just playing absolutely beautifully. I have to give him a lot of credit for the reason that BB is living. They get these high CC chains. He seems so comfortable that his healer is going to save him. He'll have the Spirit Link for a little bit, and he knows this, the riptide heal is going to top him off. Now, I think they're swapping a little bit more of that pressure onto Yo-Yo, catching him with that full Intimidation stun, forcing him to use that trinket. He knows the situation is dire. They're trying to burst Select with that Incarnation from Yo-Yo. Select really has nothing left as far as healing cooldowns. He just has that Bark Skin being forced onto himself. He does have the Iron Bar coming up in 12 seconds, but he has no Tree of Life and no Innervate. They need to really try to get this kill right here, but there's that full interrupt. Full Bash goes out of BB, and he could go down here, getting himself topped up just barely with the Spirit Link being used. Riptide healing coming out. Yo-Yo going for beautiful Cyclones. Bash goes onto U-Face, Kidney onto him. Out of that, they're trying to do as much CC as possible to peel, but Sam could be the one to go down here. But no, he gets the Riptide Shield on himself. He's at 10% HP, getting himself barely topped off. Full Trap goes out, forces the Intimidation. Sam is trying to keep his team alive, but he can't even refresh the Spirit Link at this point, and this is where things are super dire for them. They go for the Cheap Shot to Select, trying to get the cross CC out, but ZFA is falling further and further behind, and I just don't see them getting the win at this point. There's another interrupt going out to Sam. They're struggling this entire time. They really need to finish off this game. Select has almost no mana, and I think they need to find the kill condition, but no, Yo-Yo goes down. They have just too much damage. The Spirit Link is not able to be reapplied, and finally, they find the kill onto the Boomkin.
I don't even know how they lived that long. Incredible stuff coming out of ZFA, just live-lording BB and do it. This is game two of the map. ZFA, two games away from elimination. They need to find something on Ruins of Lordaeron.
I absolutely agree with Sid's analysis. I think that's the right way to go. I think maybe they can kill the pet a little bit. And potentially what I'd like to see is maybe they just need to all in at a moment that they do force trinket from Select. Maybe they just need to go for spamming purge. They need to purge off that Spirit Man. They need to purge off all the rest of Druid Huts. Those are what's going to keep Select alive in those windows. And I think that's really going to be the only way they can win this game. Now they use that Intimidation stun on Yo-Yo after he's used his trinket, putting the pressure onto BB. He's very low. Yo-Yo's got a lot of CC. Can't peel. Use that Intimidation shout. Proc the adaptation from BB. He's going to be in trouble the next time they do have that stun set up as well, because they can use the bash from Select, which they have been doing the last game. So now he has no evasion. He does have that vantage available, but he does have no adaptation. And Sam is being very patient here, holding onto that Spirit Link talent, trying not to use it as much so that he can conserve mana. And I think that this is the right play to do, especially now that Select has that Tree of Life active with the Innervate. There's this window where he's not really going to outmana the other healer. Now they go for that Stormbolt Trap, get the full CC. He does pre-Spirit Link that Stormbolt Trap, and that is a beautiful play from Sam. It's almost like he saw the animation, refresh it there. BB should be safe through the CC. He has the damage reduction, and now they're going to go for that Garou into a Kidney onto Select, forcing his trinket. So now this is a window that I think they're ready to go offensive. They have no Tree of Life. They have no Select, or they have no trinket for Select. So I think if they go for that full Kidney swap onto him, they can't get that pressure. But the only thing is they traded out Vanish and Vendetta for that go. So this means that they're not really going to have that much damage. But I think they need to find some opportunity that they can get this punish. And now with that full blind going out to Select, I think this has to be their opportunity.
Yep, they're going after U-Face. They've managed to pull Trinket and Die by the Sword. If they can keep this chain going, unfortunately, not able to get the sap onto Select, which means the crowd control chain has been dropped. And Yo-Yo is doing a much better job in game number two with these Cyclones and slowing down the pressure. Sam as well has been stepping up his gameplay, as already pointed out, using Spirit Link right before crowd control is initiated, rather than trying to maintain it the entire match, which is an unlikely successful goal to meet. You're just going to run out of mana faster than the Druid. At this point, ZFA are making excellent swaps between the Druid and the Warrior, always switching off defensive cooldowns. I really like the play from ZFA, but with crowd control secured onto Sam, BB is in trouble. Is he going to be able to pull off another miracle survival play? Amazing Cyclone, nice bash. Yo-Yo taking control of the match to allow just a little bit more time, but it's actually going to be enough. BB survives at 10% once again.
Yeah, unfortunately, that was actually because Chicken Jack's pet was dead. He was actually trying to cast a revive pet. U-Face didn't have enough damage to finish him off. And BB, again, he pulls off that miracle. He barely survives. He had the peels from Yo-Yo. He had the Thorn, slowing the Warrior when he's attacking him. And that really gave him that window to live. But no, they have the Spirit Link here. BB is super low. They got that full trap, got the adaptation, but BB's caught in that full stun. Then Yo-Yo's dipping low. And I feel like they're just so under fire here. I think Sam needs to find this window where he can use those offensive purges, especially because he's been conserving his mana with that Spirit Link. But we could see that Chicken Jack's actually using this Barrage Talent for a ton of AoE, and it's so smart with the Spirit Link. BB's so low, has the evasion, he's at 1% HP, uses that full Kinney on to select. He has no Trinket yet. This needs to be their window of opportunity. They need to finish this game up. They have the Vendetta coming up in just a second, and they have that Incarnation coming up in 30, but I don't know if they're going to live long enough. The Stormbolt comes out, a full trap comes out. BB is low, Yo-Yo is low. They need to get the burst damage, but there's a Cyclone onto U-Face. He can't connect, and I think they're somehow going to live another CC chain.
BB is just a survival legend, just hanging on by a thread, but Team Beast are looking to be in a dominant position at this point. ZFA have to pull off another miracle. They did it yesterday. Can they do it again here today? They've got a 30-second window to kill Select. If he doesn't respond appropriately, he's trying to get in bear form. He gets blinded. If he trinkets this, he's likely to get stunned, but they've already committed the kidney shot now over onto Chicken, denying the Beast of Wrath bonus damage, but really not applying any pressure. Sam falling even further behind. BB caught into a stun. Any crowd control into Sam could just close this match out. If they've got any sort of follow-up, it doesn't seem like they do. Yo-Yo retreating away, stacking up for the Spirit Link. The freezing trap was missed by Chicken Jack. That's going to leave an opening for ZFA, but it's really not a great one.
No, and that Barrage Talent, I love it. They're getting so much AoE pressure. They're abusing the Spirit Link. I mean, we might see the adaptation from Sam and BB as their talent choices, but I think Team Beast is adapting themselves. Oh. And now we see that full Kinney. They need to burst him down. He has the Iron Bark available. He has his Glider's Medallion and with his Tree of Life. If Select were to die here, I think that would be a huge mistake and a huge throw from them, but nice. A beautiful rotated Cyclone. Yo-Yo is doing exactly what you said he needed to do. We have that full trap going out onto Sam. They need to try to finish off BB, but again, he's been doing such a great job of surviving, but no, he's at 2% HP. Gets the Riptide heal, barely survives, and another kick onto Yo-Yo stops him from getting that defensive Cyclone. Finally gets it onto U-Face, and Chicken Jack, honestly, throughout this game, has been trying to stop these Cyclones at clutch moments to just barely finish off BB, but he still manages to live.
Sam's completely tapped on mana at this point. Reapplying Spirit Link is no longer an option, which means BB is going to take immense single target damage and may not survive. However, it's BB. Maybe he'll do it. Team Beast may need to try and change their target because for whatever reason, BB is just immortal. They are gunning down Select. They've got 5 more seconds on a window here if they want to go after him. But other than that, there's not really any openings with the entire team still having their trinkets to remove Kidney Shot. ZFA just have to stay alive until they can burn the rest of Select's mana. Good Cyclone, good cross crowd control. They managed to pull Barkskin, but now Sam caught into the Intimidating Shot. BB preemptively evasions, trying to avoid any incoming pressure here or dodge the incoming Intimidation stun. He may have been able to do it. Sam getting pummeled, dipping even lower, really running out of mana. Chicken Jack with a triple barrage. Everyone on the team is going to be rotting here shortly. Select is completely comfortable, although getting Cyclone with a swap now onto U-Face. If he trinkets this before Vendetta, that could be an opening, but he doesn't fall for it. BB's in trouble. Defensive Shadow Step, but U-Face charges over. Is BB going to survive again? He cheap shots him on 1% and stays alive again.
I cannot believe that play. That was absolutely beautiful. And he was so close to dying without that cheap shot, just because with that Shadow Step, U-Face got the Charge Stun on him, or Charge Root on him, rather, so he wasn't even able to continually run, even though he wasn't slowed as much as U-Face was. And it's just crazy to see him just barely hanging on here, but now he finally should go down here, 2%. HP. BB finally does die, and honestly, I have to say, I just feel like this comp pick, it's just not
map pick said.
Yep, Korea looking to send Taiwan packing here in game number 3 as Team Beast lead the series. Will Saber substituting in be enough? The Arms Warrior bringing a lot more durability and much more consistent burst windows than the Assassination Rogue. I really like this swap from ZFA, and they're leading the charge going after Select. Already huge damage off the back of that initial Stormbolt, but Saber needs to be careful. He's overextending. This is match point. He can't afford to throw the match. Trading out vital defensive cooldowns and hanging on by a thread.
Yeah, I mean, I'm so surprised. They're able to get so much damage onto this Arms Warrior, and getting all of those vital defensive cooldowns, like you said, this is going to put them in a very awful position. It feels like that Arms Warrior pick, it's very high risk, high reward. We saw that they were able to get way more damage onto Select using that Stormbolt, but at the same time, he's actually dying a lot easier than BB was on that Assassination Rogue, so I don't even know. It seems like things with ZFA, they're almost in desperation here. They use that great interrupt onto Yo-Yo, who's trying to get a defensive Cyclone, use that bash onto the Saber. They have that full trap into a Intimidating Shot that was actually overlapped, and I believe it was actually used during a Tremor Totem, so that might have been a little bit of a mistake of U-Face, maybe just feeling greedy, maybe they felt that they were really close to winning the game, and that overlap, I don't know if I really I don't know if I agree with that. I think that could have been used for a kill opportunity.
Saber pinned down, trying to get out some momentum, but they've been under fire relentlessly by Team Beast. Sam not running Spirit Link this round, but with the double stun lock, this could be it. Sam Trinkets trying to save Saber. I really like that Chicken Jack saves these counter shots for the crowd control windows. He knows that getting cycloned when Sam is in a trap would be devastating, and they're going to lose a kill opportunity. So he saves his counter shot for moments when Sam is crowd control, then uses the counter shot to interrupt incoming cyclones. That presence of mind is rank one level. Let's see, the next crowd control could close the match, Dilly. There's nothing left standing in between their way if they cross crowd control correctly. Chicken Jack moving over Uface as well. Here comes the Stormbolt. Here comes the freezing trap. Saber could be in a lot of trouble. Will he be able to survive? Yo-Yo backs him up, but actually cycloning select. I would like to see these cyclones defensively. He's trying to switch it over, but now gets countershot. Chicken Jack saved it for that important moment, but unfortunately not enough damage to find a kill.
Yeah, we can actually really see the awareness coming out from Chicken Jack. And like you're pointing out, that countershotting when you have your traps, that's the sign of a hunter that is very aware, that is very experienced, and I even watched Chicken Jack backstage. I think he's an excellent hunter, probably one of the best coming out from the Korean region, performing very well in this matchup, and we could even see, it seems like he didn't even fall for the bait to countershot when they had that clone on select, and now there's that Stormwall being used. They're trying to get the heavy pressure into select. They need to force as much damage onto him as they can, but they have to be very scared. The aspect of the wild's back up for Chicken Jack, and this is where the heavy damage comes out. Intimidation goes out as the Saber. DR Bash goes out onto him. They have the Spirit Link available, but do not use it. They use that Earthen Wall. Sam seems like he's comfortable with having the Saber stay in that, and I think that's going to be the thing that lets him stay in the game.
Even though it's looked very close for ZFA most of this match, they're in a much better position mana-wise than any other game in the series. Sam actually has a lead, and that's likely to be their win condition, ultimately. They've been trying to make... Oh, Select sitting down for a drink. Is anybody going to get over there to stop Select? No, and that mana lead is now lost. Team Beast have everything in their favor here. Another crowd control could close the match. Let's see if they can interrupt Yo-Yo Cyclones. Yo-Yo going for it, but now out of range. I really like that Chicken Jack did not waste the interrupt, knowing that his Warrior was out of range. Now a triple fear as well. No trinket for one more second. Yo-Yo gets spell reflected on the Cyclone. Nice plays from Team Beast. Perfect execution. That's going to bank them a Spirit Link totem, a vital defensive for ZFA to survive in the future.
Yeah, Team Beast are looking like absolute monsters this game. They're just playing so well, dominating ZFA the entire game. They're trying to get the pressure. I think they need to get something onto maybe Chicken Jack instead of Select, because every time they use that Stormball onto Select, they get him low, but they don't really force any defensive cooldowns. He's sitting comfortably here. He got that drink, like you said, to give him a little bit of that mana lead again. Now with that Stormbolt full trap going out, Intimidation Sun onto the Saber. He does have that Die by the Sword. He does have the Rallying Cry, but he gets bursted down in this Bash. Has to use that Die by the Sword. And I mean, I think maybe he could have just gone for that a little bit earlier, tried to hold on to it. He could have died in that Bash.
Yeah, and now they've got a Trinket from Sam and a Die by the Sword from the Warrior, which means there's a strong potential of death in Saber's near future. They make a panic swap to Select. Do they have enough damage to pull off the Miracle? Select will be jumping into Tree of Life and gaining a lot of instant cast healing, coordinating that with Innervate to make it free as well. I like that combo. It's an immediate recovery. Here comes the crowd control. Freezing Trap gets War Banner, I believe, though. Nice War Banner from Saber. This was the setup that could have ended the match with that preemptive play. He keeps his team in the fight.
Right, and I actually like the Chicken Jack. He did have his Aspect of the Wild backup, which is going to be your main burst as Beast Master Hunter. And he actually held onto it immediately once he realized the trap didn't land. A full trap. And that's actually really smart, because a lot of the time hunters will be greedy, use it once they get the thermal trap, you know, a little bit too overconfident that they're going to get that CC. But holding it now for this window where they have a ton of damage, they're trying to get the counter pressure. Select is being hit very heavily. They force him to use that Iron Bark, but he does hold on to his Glider's Medallion, so he should be able to be safe. They have the Stormbolt trap coming out. There's high damage coming out from the Beastmaster Hunter. Yo-Yo is getting pressured, has the Bark skin on himself. They're trying to get that damage out. Intimidating Shout goes out defensively, though, hitting Chicken Jack, his pets, and Select.
Yeah, switching targets to try and benefit from no Earth Shield. Saber has been targeted most of this fight, so it's likely that Sam committed defensives to him and Earth Shield. So they switched targets and they managed to bank a defensive from Yo-Yo. Now both Saber and Yo-Yo are at risk of dying in the next crowd control chain. But also ZFA have managed to secure another mana lead over Select, and they've got Starfall on Select. He's not able to drink while he's inside of this. Nice moves from Yo-Yo. If they can keep denying these drinks and start establishing a significant mana lead into dampening, there's still opportunity for them to swing back in the series. We see Sam getting countershot, which means Yo-Yo will will be free to spam out Cyclones, but they're trying to gun down Select. They haven't really been able to do too much chasing him. I'd really like to see more damage on a different target, but in the meantime, a freezing trap, triple crowd control secured. Team Beast trying to push for a win. Saber survives at 50%. Sam out of crowd control. Yo-Yo now going for defensive Cyclones, trying to pause out the fight so Sam doesn't have to burn too much damage recovering off the back of this exchange.
I want to see them killing that Beastmastery Hunter pet. I think it's actually really easy for Arms Warrior Boomkin to get that kill out there, and I think that's going to shut down a lot of the pressure coming out from Team Beast, and that will definitely let them win a mana war. So I feel like that should be what they're going for. I think they need to win the mana war. We've seen Sam doing it a lot better, not using that Spirit Link talent. We could see that, you know, with that consistent pressure from the Arms Warrior, because they have the Mortal Wounds effect, it's forcing Select to use a little bit more mana. Now, Assassination Rogue has that too, but not as strong as the Arms Warriors is, and not as strong as the Sharpened Blade, which can reduce a lot of effective healing. Now they're hitting Chicken Jack. I agree this is the right target to hit. They have a lot of pressure going on to him. We have the Saber getting really low. He has the Die by the Sword coming up in 20 seconds, so Sam is just going to trade out that Trinket. They had it full Intimidating Shout. Things should be looking good for them. I feel like ZFA is stabilizing. I think they just really need to try to go into Chicken Jack, try to kill his pet, especially if they can force the aspect of the turtle and then kill his pet. It's going to be very difficult for him to reliably get one back up.
This is the winning strategy from ZFA, to go after Chicken Jack and try and Cyclone Select, but it might be a little bit too late. And being on match point, if they've been executing this strategy from game one, they could have actually been up 2-0 in the series. There's a lot on the line. Are they going to be able to handle the pressure? Crowd control traded out for Team Beast. They don't manage to have the War Banner, and Yo-Yo's in execute range, ducking for cover around the corner. Renewal bounces his health back. He survives this crowd control chain, but the next one is likely to close the match. Yo-Yo activates Incarn. They need to pull off a miracle, but they're going after Select, and I don't like this trade. I feel it's not likely that he goes down. Maybe. Saber's dishing a ton of damage around the corner. Select now recovering with that Innervate combo. This healing all free, but the mana lead is still in favor of Sam if they can hang on just a bit longer. Saber jumping back, Blade Storming, trying to peel, maybe eat a freezing trap, but a couple inches too far away, and Yo-Yo's in trouble. Team Beast will be advancing.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.